Welcome to the BuildBlock ICF Installer Training Series.
Communicating cuts, spaces and bars method. Communication is extremely important on the job site, so it's best to agree on a standard system for identifying the size and spacing of block cuts. One way to identify the size and spacing is the spaces and bars method. This method not only describes the length of a cut, but also ensures that when cut, the spacing will be consistent, keeping webs aligned properly. The spacing and bars method uses three sets of numbers. For this video, we will use the example 2, 4, 2. For this method, a bar references the 1 inch of foam that is between two cut lines. The first number refers to the number of vertical bars of foam before coming to a web. The second number is the number of webs. The third number is the number of vertical bars of foam after the webs are counted. So for example, our 2-4-2 block would look like this. The first two means that there are two vertical bars of foam before hitting a web. When using BuildBlock ICFs, these vertical bars are each 1 inch of foam. The 1 inch repeating pattern and integrated cut lines and tape measure also make it very easy to cut correctly. The second number, 4, means the block needs 4 webs. BuildBlock ICF webs are spaced every 6 inches. In this example, there would be 18 inches between the 4 webs and an extra 2 inches for the final web itself. The last number, 2, means that we have another 2 vertical bars or 2 inches of foam after the last web. When these numbers are added together, you will have a total block length of 24 inches. As blocks are cut and walls are stacked, it's important that web spacing stays the same throughout. Not all cuts are created equal, so simply grabbing a 24-inch block for an open space does not mean the webs will align correctly. For example, not every 24-inch block will have 2 inches of foam on either side of the web. A 0-4-4 block or a 1-4-3 block are also 24 inches long, but may end up placing webs too close or too far away to the surrounding blocks. With the bars and spaces method, you're not just filling a space, you're using a specific cut block to fill the space correctly. This method, along with the 1-inch repeating pattern, makes sure you can use any scrap block and integrate it into the wall as long as it has at least 1 web. The spaces and bars method is a quick and efficient way to implement block cuts into an ICF wall. When used properly, it ensures the walls are secure, webs are spaced evenly, and less material is wasted. With a little practical application on site, this method will become a common language between you and your team. One last tip. When many of the cuts you make will repeat every other course, use a permanent marker to write any special cuts or other notes on the wall. This saves time for everyone and keeps your project moving. Thank you for watching this video in the BuildBlock ICF Installer Training Series. For more information and other videos in this series, please visit our website at buildblock.com/training or our YouTube channel at youtube.com/buildblock.